Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. Right, I'm going to show you how to do something called Scratch Addition. It's a quick and easy way to add a column of numbers. So let's say you had something like this: 8, 9, 3, 5, 7, 6, just a bunch of numbers you had to add, right? So there's a column of numbers. So one way is to think of it in your head, but it's easy to get lost. So normally people say 8 and 9 is 17, right? And then 17 and 3 is 20. And then 20 and 5 is 25. And then now you have to think, where was I? Oh yeah, 25. 25 and 7, 32. 32 and 6 is 38, and hopefully I got that right. But what's happening is I have to keep all these numbers in my head. Now, there are other things people do to add numbers quickly, which is not scratch addition, and that's by kind of combining numbers that kind of add up together or adding a couple numbers at a time. So some people might notice that these three numbers, 8, 9, and 3, 17 and 3 add up to 20, so those add up to 20 so far. And then they might say, well, these two numbers add up to 12, and then I've got 6, and then that's another way to get 38. Okay, that's not scratch addition, but that's a way of like kind of just adding a few numbers together at a time. Someone else might say, I wonder if there's any easy sets of numbers I could add together, and they'll notice like the 7 and 3 add up to 10, so that's up to 10 so far. And then they might say, well, let's see. 6 and 5 here add up to 11, right? Plus that 9 is 20, so then they think that, and then you've got the 8. Again, different ways of adding these numbers up. Remember, we had actually a 3 here. Okay, I'm going to show you something a little bit different though. All right, so this isn't the only way to obviously quickly add a bunch of numbers up. Instead of keeping numbers in your head that are over and head, we're going to scratch out a number. So watch how this works. 8 and 9 is 17. Now normally you write 17 like this, right? What I'm going to do is here's how I'm going to write 17. I'm going to scratch and write the number 7 right next to it. And then I'm going to add 7 and 3. 7 and 3 is 10. Look at how I'm going to write 10. So instead of writing a 1, you just scratch a number out. Then 0 and 5 is 5. If I want, I could write that down. 5 and 7 is 12. So I see how I'm writing 12. And then 2 and 6 is 8. And the last thing you get, that's going to be the ones column. You see how many numbers you scratch out? That's how many tens there were. 10, 20, 30. So this is the number 38. So let's do that again. We've got 8, 9, 3. 5, 7, and 6. And you don't have to write these numbers on the right, because to do this again, actually, you could just put the video on rewind and watch what I did. Now, watch me do this by keeping the numbers in my head. So I think 8 and 9 is 17. I'm going to just remember the 7. 7 and 3 is 10. I'm going to remember the 0. 0 and 5 is 5. 5 and 7 is 12. I'm just going to think 2. And what's left is an 8. I count the number, how many times I made scratches. And that's the tens column again. So you could either write down that number or keep it in your head. One more time. Okay, so let's do it again. So what you could think of, instead of thinking of the number 17, some people actually think about it this way. 8 and 7 is scratch 7. 7 and 3 is scratch 0. See, instead of writing the number 10, you think scratch 0. 0 and 5 is 5. 5 and 7 is scratch 2. 2 and 6 is 8. And count those numbers, 38. So you see the idea why we call it scratch. Okay, whether or not you write these little numbers down or keep that number in your head, oh, by the way, I ended up writing a 2 here. I didn't keep that number 2 in my head. You still end up with 8 in the ones column. So let's try it on another column of numbers. All right, so here we have a column of numbers again. By the way, I learned this method from a really old book before there were calculators, back in, I think, the 30s or 40s it was written, and it was for accountants. How to quickly add a bunch of numbers together. All right, so again, lots of ways people might add these numbers. They might just, start 7 and 6 is 13, keep that in their head. 13 and 5 is 18, 18 and 9 is 27, 27 and 8 is 35, 35 and 4 is 39. 39 and 6, let's say that's 45. 45 and 7 is 52. So I think it's 52 if I didn't make any mistakes. All right, so the question is, I wonder if it's 52. So easy when you're adding all those digits up to make a mistake somewhere. So let's do the scratch method. Right, so I'm going to write down the ones just so that you could see what I could be thinking in my head. You could keep that number in your head, or if you don't have a piece of paper, some people just put their finger up instead of writing a scratch. So when they do 7 and 3, they actually put one of their fingers up and think the number 3 for 13. But I'm going to do it with a scratch. 7 and 6 is 13. 3 and 5 is 8. 8 and 9 is 17. 7 and 8 is 15. 5 and 4 is 9. 9 and 6 is 15. 5 and 7 is 12. Count the scratches. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I did get soy. Looks like I did it right. Now, of course, like I said, you could keep those numbers in your head. So just listen and see if you could follow along what's going on when I do it in my head. 7 and 6, 3. 3 and 5, 8. 8 and 9, 7. 7 and 8, 5. 5 and 4, 9. 9 and 6 is 5. 5 and 7 is 12. See, I write the 2 at the bottom, and I'm adding up the 5. So you could say it to yourself, or you could write the digits down. It's easier to write the digits down if you have a piece of paper anyway. And lastly, if you don't find this any easier, by all means, don't use it. It's just kind of a fun method. You could just put groups of numbers together. A lot of people do that. So they might notice that, let's say, 4 and 6 add up to 10, right? And then I notice right here I've got a 6 and a 5, 11 and 9 is 20, so I'm up to 20 so far. And then I've got 7 and 8, that's 15. And then I have that 7. And then that's another way to do it. You just sort of add, pairs of numbers or three numbers together to get easy numbers, and then go ahead and add, and you're still going to get 52. So just different ways. This is not the scratch method the way I did it in green, although it looks like it, kind of. I was just scratching out the numbers I already used up. So this is just a method that if you find it useful, you could use for adding a column of numbers. How about you try one? So here's a big column of numbers. So why don't you get out a piece of paper and try it? See if you can get it using the scratch method. Okay, here I'm going to go for it. I'm going to write down the digits. To me, it's just as easy as like keeping anything in my head. So 8 and 6, 4. 4 and 3 is 7. 7 and 9 is 16. I was just saying the ones digit. Let me say the actual number. Okay, 8 and 6, 14. 4 and 3, 7. 7 and 9, 16. 6 and 7, 13. 3 and 6, 9. 9 and 4, 13. 3 and 8, 11. 1 and 5 is 6. Add the scratches. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I've also seen people do this just using a dot instead of a scratch. So let's do it that way. 8, 6, 3, 9, 7, 6, 4, 8, 5. With a dot, every time it adds up to, instead of writing, scratching out a number, you just put a dot. So 8 and 6 is 13. 3 and 3 is 6. Oops, I'm sorry. 8 and 6 is not 13. 8 and 6 is 14. 4 and 3 is 7. 7 and 9 is 16. 6 and 7 is 13. 3 and 6 is 9. 9 and 4 is 13. 3 and 8 is 11, and 1 and 5 is 6. So did you see what I did? Instead of scratching, I just put a dot. Instead of writing 14, I put a dot 4, a dot 6, a dot 3, etc. So I still end up with a 6, and now I just count the dots. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, I did it twice and I got 56, so you know what? I think that's the right answer. And those of you who want to do it some other way, like combining a couple numbers at a time, that works as well. Or combining two numbers at a time, that's another strategy people use just in a row. They might say, well, the first two numbers add up to, I do this a lot actually, the first two numbers are 14, the next two numbers are 12, the next two numbers are 13, the next two numbers are 12, and I got a 5. And then they add, they've got less numbers to add at a time. But then you still have five numbers here over here, right? You could do it again. But let's just do it from here. You've got 4 and 2 is 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 16. I just keep getting 56 no matter how you look at it. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com where you can view all of my videos which are organized by topic.